Tiger style.
Tiger style.
Yo. Huh. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to fuck with. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to fuck with. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to fuck with.
There's no place to hide as I step inside the room. Dr. Doom, prepare for the boom. Bam! Oh, man! Ah, slam! Damn!
I scream like Tarzan.
I be tossing and forcing. My style is awesome. I'm causing more family food than Richard Dawson. And the survey said, you're dead. Fatal flying guillotine chops off your fucking head. Mister, who is that?
Hey, yo!
The Wu is back. Making niggas go bro, bro. Like I'm Super Jack. Me fear no.
Where's the camera?
Oh no, here comes the Wu.
Change Shogun. Who you got? Take it back. Yo, what's up, everybody? Yo,
what up?
It's your boy Killer Priest.
Ah!
Yo, welcome to back to the Killer Priest podcast. And we got a special guest. Goes back, yo.
You smell me?
We got turned up already. We got Tiger style, y'all. Make
what's
some
up?
Noise.
What's up? What's up? What's
gonna
up?
Give some AD.
Thank you.
Wanna say shout out to AD in the house. What up, Tiger?
What up?
Tiger style, man.
That's what's up.
That's good, man.
Yeah, man. Thank you for having me, Pri. I appreciate y'all, man.
What's
good to
going
see my
on?
Man, AD, man.
Yeah, that's what's up, man.
Podcast is lit.
Yeah, man. Thank you. Thank
I should have
yeah,
worn
yeah.
my Wu-Tang shirt. So,
nah. That's all
I feel
great.
Like I'm down bipartisan, though. Like I'm here. I'm going to lie and say I'm in the crew for at least 5 minutes.
He's going to be training me, too, man. I see
yes,
you,
sir.
I see you got your...
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey. I'm gonna get my guy. When don't get mad at him either. Don't get mad at him neither. They're gonna be able to punch diamonds at you.
That was a line. That was a dope verse right there.
That's serious. You're gonna be able to punch diamonds
that's
out
a lyricist.
You.
That's serious, a lyricist man. For you. Yeah.
No,
yeah,
man,
yeah.
It's good to be here, man. Thank you yeah. so much for having me. I'm
thank
very humble. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you for coming.
And thank
man.
You for coming on my show last night, man.
That was hard.
Dope.
That was hard.
That
bro.
Was fucking dope.
Yeah, man.
The
that
King
was
Vitamin
hard.
Shit was classic. You said King Vitamin was like a bootleg Cap'n Crunch.
It was.
He called it.
It is.
Ah. It was, though. Agree. It was, though. It was like, what is he the king of? King vitamins. No kids want vitamins. None.
There was no vitamins in there.
None. There's no vitamins in there. It was just poor taste.
Yeah, man.
Poor taste.
Peace to everybody that's coming in. Oh, yeah.
All right.
I see Millionaire Aaron's in
how
the
your
house.
How mama doing? How everybody doing?
Yeah, exactly.
What's up?
Yo, so it's going to be nice. So how it all started, man. So tell us...
Okay.
The genesis, man. Your genesis.
Man, I'm a Midwest dude. Like, first of all, I've been living out here in California for like, 25 of them almost, like a quarter, you know, 25 years or so. Yeah, I originally came out here in the 90s, and I'm from the Midwest. My family is predominantly from Chicago, you know.
All right, Chi-Town. Yeah. Shout out to the Chi.
That's what's up. Old school Chi.
Yeah.
And then we migrated to a small area that's right there that a lot of people don't know about. Got crazy talent and a lot of things going on in the Quad Cities, right? Which is right there. You got Davenport, you got Moline, you got Rock Island, you know, Bettendorf, you got... You know, East Moline, all these little cities that are right here that surround the Mississippi River. So I was bred in that area. And my grandparents, they had a restaurant there. You know,
we
all kind of nurtured around that area on that block on a corner called 6th and Vine.
Right.
And we were kind of like the center of the community. Kind of like how Roscoe's kind of got that soul vibe here in L.A.,
right?
We were that for that small community. And it was like the spot where everybody went.
Right. You know? And where's this at?
This is in Davenport, Iowa.
Okay.
Right? So, the bridge separates the two states.
Right,
you got
right.
Iowa on one side, Illinois on the other side.
Right, gotcha.
And people don't even believe that, like, black people live there. And it's where all the mixed kids come from. If you want to know where all these tall basketball stars with
Iowa.
Manila colored skin are coming from, it's from our area. Just saying. Yeah, so that's where it is. And so we came up there, man. I came up on that block, man, and just being in that, it's like the pool hall vibe, you know?
So right.
Pool hall restaurant kind of thing.
Mm.
My grandparents, just, you know, they kept the corner with a certain kind of tone and
vibe.
And I was just always around music, you know, all of that. You know, yeah, like a lot of people don't understand, like we have some very big individuals that come from just that small area. Michael Nunn.
Mm-hmm.
Michael Second to None, you know, former middleweight champ.
Yeah.
Jesse Johnson from The Time. You know?
Right. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Jesse Johnson from The Time, right?
Time. Yep, shout
right
out there, the
you know what I'm saying?
R.I.P.
Yeah, man. Roger Craig from the 49ers, man.
Wow.
Who should be in the Hall of Fame.
Wow.
49ers fuck up twice. They don't put put Roger Craig in the Hall of Fame and then...
It's going to get deep.
And then here we go. We got Kaepernick. Anyway. but Roger Craig, these guys are from this way. And it's like... just growing up in that neighborhood, man, it was so much soul, so much vibe and stuff like that, man. We had dudes that was into breakdancing, hip hop, and being in the Midwest is kind of tough because you got the privy of, you know, like on the East Coast, y'all expected to have that hip hop respect, you know? And on the West Coast, same thing.
Right.
Well, we kind of had the same thing until the South got it, the Midwest, and still to this day, kind of still doesn't get that light for having that kind of energy, you know, that kind of talent there. You know, so a lot of people, we have
to... Mark Kelly.
Yeah, well, you know, that's R&B. Shout out R. Kelly, you know what I'm saying? But you know, like, we have to migrate to other places is the point. And that's what I did at a young age. Like, when I graduated high school, I just came out to Cali. My mom was in Cali.
Right.
You know, I wanted to go to Atlanta and go to, you know, historically black college. Mm. But then I just said, you know, I'm going to go to Cali and see what to do.
Okay.
Know? And I came out here and then...
Genesis.
Yeah, making that transition out here. I've been a dancer my whole life just as a kid.
Right.
You know, just as a kid dancing, breakdancing and all of that kind of stuff. Yeah, and then when I got out here... Like, I was bored for the first few months, and then one of my friends, my coworkers, well, not a coworker, but a guy who worked across the mall from me.
Right.
We got to be cool, and he said, man, I'm going to take you out. So he took me out to this spot called the Palace in Hollywood, and I went to, like, this little dance ball, and it was crazy, because all kinds of dances in there.
Yeah.
And that
L.A. is known, big up the L.A. is known for
pop. Oh, my God, man, the hip-hop is crazy, you know? And, like, when I was in high school, I ain't going to front to you, like, you know, I was, like, into everything. So I was into, you know, hip-hop, but I was also into, like, my New Edition and my Troop, and Bobby Brown was my hero, you feel me? Like, I thought I was, like, a light-skinned Bobby Brown. I knew everything the dude did, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And when I came here to Cali, it was like, boom, I get to see these kids that are deep in the culture more,
right,
in the hip-hop more, like, the dancing and all. It was, like, lit. It was a whole different thing. Crumping and all of that. So I got absorbed into that, you know what I mean? And that night, particularly, it led to me meeting my first manager and mentor, Eric Kasim. And he was the dance coordinator for Soul Train. He was the guy who was responsible for getting all the dancers on the show.
Yeah. And he just Hold on, we're about to get deep because he about to let y'all know. So let me let them know before you let them know.
Okay. All right.
Yo, he was a dancer for Soul Train.
Yeah, for like about two, three seasons I was on there. Yeah, I did a lot of different.
Find the footage.
Do a lot of different. It's out there on YouTube. I ain't fronting. It's out there. Yeah. But it led to me and him. He was giving out tickets that night to Soul Train, these little tickets. It was like some Willy Wonka, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So he's giving out tickets, you know what I'm saying? He skipped me up, and I was kind of like, what the fuck? What you giving? So I went calling him, you know, small, you know, make a big, long story short. You know, I got him to give me a ticket to Soul Train. You know, we came. Man, I got to meet so many friends, man. Some of the dancers on the show, you know, Lusky, or the dude poses, and, you know, my man Otis that wears the mask.
Yeah.
All of these different people, man. Bernadette, all the girls are gonna, you know, these are all my like big sisters.
Wow.
And brothers, because when I
Did you meet Shabadoo?
No, I did not. I wish I would have, man. If I would have met Ozone, are you kidding me? At that time, too?
Yeah.
But I did meet Shrimp. I did meet Shrimp.
Wow.
I met him in a club, actually.
For guys who don't know, that's the dude.
That's Turbo.
That's Turbo, yeah.
With the broom and shit, breaking. Yeah, so I met him at a club and got to actually cypher with him in a dance cypher, so that was dope. How about that? Amazing. I got to see him getting down.
Amazing.
That's what's up. Shout out Boogaloo Shrimp.
Yeah.
So, but just getting on that show on Soul Train, man, I met so many people because that was when it was kind of transitioning from, like, the dudes that was dressing more, R&B with the shoes and slacks and those. And you saw more hoodies coming in.
Right.
Baseball caps.
Uh-huh.
Baggy switching stuff. Up. You know what I'm saying? Switching it up. Cross colors at that time. And the Carl Canavas and all that. All
right.
So I was at a perfect time when hip hop was coming in. And I'm loudmouth on the set. Like, I'm trying to, you know, I'm here and I'm trying to get noticed. You
right.
So I would be bugging my man Eric Kasim. Like, yo, man. Like, I'm saying, like, let me get up here, man. Let me get over here, man. Let me get on the thing, man. Like, da-da-da-da-da. You know, nagging him for, like, different stuff like this. You know what I'm saying? And he was like, you really serious, huh? And I was like, yo, man, I ain't come here to play, man. I'm hungry. This is me at 18.
Wow.
So he was like, look, I'm going to introduce you to somebody. So he took me to...
18 on Soul Train.
18, man.
Wow.
So he took me to one of my good friend's house, man, for the first time to help me put my demo together, right? Because I didn't have any kind of connection to dudes musically out here at that time.
Right.
So he took me, and it was kind of... I wish I would have got more on the hip-hop side, but I don't regret it because I went to some really fine key musicians that were like... They were more R&B based, and they were players and stuff,
right,
but they just were good at music. Mm. So they taught me how to sound better.
Mm.
And I learned that craft first before I even got deep into the hip-hop side of what was going on in L.A. and the ciphering and all that.
Right, yeah, yeah.
I was learning how to perfect myself, find my voice and how to sound right and how to edit my vocals. And,
yeah.
So I was getting all of this master treatment.
Yeah, master
that would come back into me, play years later, you know what I'm saying, that I didn't even know. Wow. Now, let me tell you some of the people. So my man James Reese was the guy. He talked me to James Reese. James Reese was working with Tina Marie at this time. Tina Marie, rest in peace, big sis, was working on an album called Ivory. And over here in Bela Studios in Hollywood, one night James was recording this song called Just Us Two. And he was like, yo, Tiger, come up into the studio. And that's when I was young and, you know, young enough to do that. I got up like late at night and ran up to the studio, you know what I mean? And was sitting there with him just all night. We vibing. And he was like, yo, go get in the booth. This is between him taking joints. He was like, I'm going to put the beat at you and just freestyle. So I was like, all right. I started saying some old silly shit, started freestyling. Well, he kept it, mixed it, and then he played it for her. So she came to the studio, and she sat here and she heard it. And she like, you know, I'm sitting there like thinking she's going to be mad. Like, but she was like, is this you? I was like, yeah. She's like, I like that. We're going to keep that. I like that. What? So they used it as an edit on it. That was back when they was doing the maxi singles. Remember those?
Yeah.
The $5 maxi CD singles?
Yes.
So she
yes,
put me on a little extra yes, dub version on there. Yeah, the Roxbury dub. You dig?
What's the name of it?
And the name of the song is called Just Us 2. Yeah, Justice Tina 2. Marie. Yeah. And yes, I had like a little rap on there.
Okay. We got to pull that up, AD.
They put me on there as Tony D. Tiger. Everybody never got my name wrong all the time.
Oh, man.
You know, you call yourself Tony. Your name is Tony, and then you call yourself Tiger. Everybody's like, hey, Tony the Tiger. They just, it's be Tony the Tiger. Yeah, just every time. Tony the Tiger. Like, goddamn, every time.
Is it on YouTube?
Or? So, yeah. I don't know. You know what? I'm not sure if it's even up or out there like that, because that was like in 91. I want to say 90, 91.
Is there a video you want to start with?
yeah, man, it's crazy, but.
You can read some of the comments right there.
What's some, okay, yeah, check it out. Let me see.
So, somebody asked where you.
Somebody asked what?
Sponsored by Afro Sheen?
Was I sponsored by Afro Sheen? Now, you don't want to play the dozens with me because I'm from the South Side. I'm going to let you know. It's like playing jokes with. Like Jamie Foxx. You know what happened with LL?
Right, right.
Get mad at me. No, I was not sponsored by that.
Oh, man. We gotta hear that song.
The Justice 2?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was silly whack. That was so whack, it's not even fair. No,
bro,
don't even
for
do
the
it.
Time, for the
yeah,
time.
I was like 18, man. Yeah. Now, yeah. I have some joints that I done did over the years. Now, that's dope. That's Keep Your Rep right there. That's a joint I did. My man, shout out Doobie Raider. My man Feliano did this joint. I did the video myself.
My pedigree is vintage Teddy Pendergrass. Turn off the light, light a candle, and let the speakers blast.
That's crazy. I did this shit on my phone. Can you believe it? We speak and laugh, it's a funny story behind this video.
Speaking their merely minute math. Find me killing it how I do.
Freaking peace to the gods.
Stab wounds. Woo! Included for y'all crew. Y'all need to talk it through, dog. I'm worse than a bark. I'm a biting thug.
Hey, shot the video yourself.
Yeah, man. Pull up on into shot it on my phone. This is I couldn't get nobody status to do a music video for me, man. Everybody was fronting. People would ask me to get in this shit. And I'd be like, yo, help me shoot a video. I was sitting on the couch and I was like, you know what?
And know it's real, for real.
I know what I want to see in the fucking shot. So I'm gonna go and just get some footage.
I had to sacrifice some
and
friends.
All of that's in the art district downtown by where I live. So yeah.
All right.
So I just went and set up spots and just got shots.
That's fine. Yeah, that's fine.
And just came home and edited.
What year was this?
This was probably, I don't know, what year is it sound at? Because that was like several years ago. 2015. Yeah, it was a while back. Yeah, man Doobie Raider, shout out Filiano. He gave me that track and I just did it. And I was sitting on it. I was like, man, you know how that is. You got like dope songs.
Yeah.
And you ain't got the right visuals or the right whatever else for it. So you can't move. And I'm like, man, somebody get on me with a video. I'm just trying to get it on the video. Everybody was like, yeah, man, well, you know, you got to start around $5,000. You're going to need a crew of, you know, so many people. We're going to need such and such. And then plus I need my fee for hooking you up. I was like, damn, that's how we doing it? Now, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to fucking film it with my phone. How about that?
Yeah.
So I went out and I just filmed it and I edited it and there it is.
You filmed that with your phone?
Yeah, I did all that myself on the phone.
And you edited it on the phone.
And then, I downloaded a program called Wondershare Movie Maker, and I sat there and I just taught myself how to edit. I had no clue what the hell I was doing.
Dope.
I just knew what I wanted to see.
Hey, yeah, exactly.
And it's just like when you're writing. It's just like when you're writing and you're doing, you know, any kind of stuff like that. It's like, it's just, you know what you want to see. You got to just be patient and be isolated, and you can have time to sit there and master your craft.
Right.
This is what
this was a fun moment.
You did at my spot.
Yes.
This yeah, we both day. Got something in common. We both go back with AD, huh? Yeah.
Yes, we do. Because I remember he's been telling me about you for years. He's been trying to make this happen.
So, Priest used to record in that booth, too.
Yeah.
Yo, this right here, this is somebody else's beat.
Didn't know I'm ahead by three spaces. Scuffing your force ones and leaving dirt across your laces. I might snap and stab you in a few places.
So if you're really smart, you'd R. Kelly and change faces. It's T squared and not the Pied Eye Piper.
Make gorillas turn his pillows, Michelle Pfeiffer. They say I'm liver than the average joke. Cause my average is kinda savage, I'm just letting you know.
If come on in.
If you plan to front, my advice is bring some back with it. I'll smack the cheek out your mouth and say the track did it.
Yeah.
It's funny, someone ever don't get it. When I swarm, dog, it's hard to perform. I fuck with it and I feel it.
I'm a necessary link in the chain, like Dick Grayson and Alfred are to help Bruce Wayne.
Man, just give him the instrumental and let him go.
I just want to point out some of the quotables because people don't be listening. That's what I was trying to tell you, man. I listened to the lyrics.
Wow.
And I heard the jewels that you be saying on your songs, man. That's why I was like, man, come on, man. Real music. Take a heartbeat and loop it. I was like, oh, stop there. But the man hits you with 60 more before the 16th bar. What are we talking about right now?
Man. Seriously. We was at a thank you, by the way. We was at Tina Marie.
Tina Marie. Tina Marie. Well, on that was just what happened. She put out, you know, I got to be on that little extra dub, which was a good little experience.
Right.
Then from there to put together the demo,
right.
James Reese invited me to the studio one time when he was recording at Herb Albert's famous A&M Records over in La Brea, right?
Right.
So he was like, yo, just come up here, man. We recording and we doing some mixing and stuff. And he was like, I'm with some good shout-out legendaries. Michael Mixon Moore, legendary to Los Angeles. You know what I'm saying? Booker, who was famous for Brandy's first album, Baby.
Right.
And all of that. He did all of that. Mixed all of that.
Oh, wow.
So these guys are big brothers.
So he was learning all the inside.
So these are big brothers. Right, I come to the studio and I'm just meeting these people. I'm like, oh, okay, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. And they would be like schooling me. I'm like, really? Like, I don't know who you are, but whatever. But that's some good shit. What you saying? what you saying makes sense, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And so when we get to this La Brea Studios, I get to record a few songs to start getting my demo together. Right. I got to meet Herb Albert, which was beautiful. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know,
Herb Albert,
and,
man.
You know, Luther Vandross was at the studio one day. I was recording one of my songs. He's two rooms over, you know, I get to meet him.
Wow.
So it was, I mean, come on, man. I'm like a kid.
Luther Vandross, you know? Man.
Yeah, and I'm a kid from the Midwest, so it was really dope.
Sorry. I got to meet him before.
Yeah, it was really, really nice people, man. Really, really cool people. So had that experience, and like I said, man, just them guys sitting on my helmet. Like, I even remember Michael Mixon Moore, rest in peace, he used to be on my helmet, like, this bad. Like, I would say some word, and you know how you searching for a word when you rhyme and you just throw something in there. You're like, oh, they don't really matter. They ain't going to pay attention to that word.
Yeah.
They ain't going to pay attention to that word. It ain't like they're going to be whatever. And Michael Moore would be the guy who would be like, yo, hold up. You said the such and such and such and such. Yeah. What does that mean? Yeah. And I'll be like, I don't know. It just sound good. Like, no. It can't just sound good. Make it make sense. Like, write some new shit. So he would be on my helmet and make, damn, okay, that made me really start focusing on my content. Like, I gotta start paying attention to what I'm saying. Like, it ain't just about just making it sound good. Yada yada yada. So these same principles, of course, that I learned from these dudes who I know who I did it, I just been living by them, and I share the same things with other artists that's younger than me. You know, like, I always been that kind of dude to pay it forward. Like, boom, boom, boom. Like, you know, like, I can tell you back in the day, and a lot of people don't know this, like Crooked Eye. Crooked Eye is one of the little homies.
Shout out to Crook.
Shout out to King Crook, man. Yeah. Like, when me and my crew, the superheroes, like, we was kind of a Wu-Tang in ourselves because we all from different places. I'm from the Midwest. We got a couple guys from New York. You know, we had a couple dudes from the West Coast, right?
Okay.
And we was like that. Suit the Hall of Justice and all of this.
Oh, okay. This is a crew.
Yeah, we were a crew.
This you and King
was,
Crook?
Yeah, this is. Wow. No. Crook was just like
Crook
the younger
is
homie.
Yeah,
Crook was the younger homie that recorded at the same studio with us. So, Chucky Miller was a cat that had a studio right there in Long Beach off of Willow and Atlantic.
Right.
And Line Block used to record there. They were from Long Beach. And Crooked Eye was like his real main young artist that he was trying to develop. He was at a younger stage at that time, right?
Mm.
And
then it's making sense to me now. Now I know why AD. Didn't you say you recorded Crook one time, right?
Yeah. I got a track that I recorded him. I recorded him before he was famous.
Okay.
I recorded him before he was famous. He was with J.U. Nice.
See, that's crazy. That's how that shit go together, because everybody going to everybody's studio back then.
Yeah, you part my try, ADD. Go ahead.
No, it's all good. Because it's like that, because you end up being just 6 inches away from working with the same person. You know what I'm saying? Just like how me and you've been working with AD forever.
That's right.
But it's just like just till now. You feel me? Like, we just get to cross the street. So it's just a matter of timing. But
Crazy.
Crook used to be one of the younger brothers that used to record at the studio at that time.
Okay.
And the producer, the RZA and our crew,
okay,
was DLS. Shout out DLS. And
shout out to DLS.
He would be like, yo, he produced for Crooked Eye, he produced for Lionbrock, and he also did our stuff.
Right.
So when we would be there, we would be having writing sessions, seven dudes sitting in a room with books. You know how that go.
Yeah.
And we all sitting there trying to come up with the song. Crooked Eye would just walk in like we just recording. You
right.
know what I mean?
We get this is before he was.
Yeah, this is before he was, yeah. And we would get the ciphering and stuff, and he would be like the little bro sticking his head in.
Right.
Because he wasn't really on hip hop like that at that time.
Right.
You know what I mean? He was still kind of finding his voice, you feel me?
Right.
And he was kind of more like on the Snoop style, to be more exact. You know, it was kind of like that. He sounded a little bit more like that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy. What a drastic change.
Yeah, so I used to tell him, like, yo, man, you know, you got that Snoop thing, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But when you get ready to get in that game, you're going to have to kind of still have your own thing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like we were talking about yesterday.
Yeah.
So
yep.
I know he started just listening to hip-hop, vibing around hip-hop heads like us, different stuff like that. He got really into Razzcast from what I heard as well.
Mm. Shout out to Razzcast.
And then, boom, I see my little brother. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I see my little brother, and he then became this thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly.
So it's dope, man. It's,
oh, shit.
It's
Mojitos in the house.
Yeah, it's up. That's all right.
You knew Mojito when he was little?
Yeah, I remember when he was just a kitty.
Yeah.
But that's where that came from.
We're like, scratching.
That's where that came from. That Long Beach community vibe has always been real cool like that. You know, you had our crew doing our thing there in Long Beach. You had Crook, you had all these different cats I know. And it's crazy, man, that I done got the privilege, I'm gonna call it, to be in certain situations at the right times. I done been in studios with a lot of different cats out here in LA, and I can vouch for LA and Long Beach. Long Beach as well. Just Long Beach alone has a lot of talent that's untapped. Like Long Beach, California. Oh my God, man. Yeah. Everybody, when you see Long Beach, you say Snoop. Yeah, okay, dude.
Right.
That's just one thing, bro. That's like saying Dre in LA. You know?
Right. So much more. Yeah,
you know
so
what I'm
much
saying?
More. Yeah.
And it's just like that in Long Beach. You got bands that are dope.
Wow.
You know, to kind of have that sublime kind of feel, you know?
Makes sense.
Groups like Chapter 11, you know what I'm saying? Everybody knows Long Beach Dub All-Stars, and, you know, some of these guys are a little bit more popular.
Right.
But you got hot artists in Long Beach. Filiano, you know, the Mexicans, Capital I, my guy, shout out.
You know, shout out to, you got
a lot of these dudes, man, that are really, really dope-ass dudes. And Compton as well, too. You can't leave out Compton. People sleep on Compton. They think it's all gangster stuff. But that, I found in the trenches of just being in that mix of hip-hop for me, ciphering and trying to always find the kill. And, you know, as a dude that loved to cipher and battle and beast. Like, I'm always trying to find the kill,
you know?
I want to meet my Thanos, you feel me? Like, I want to meet the dude who I need to meet you.
Right.
I'm like a summer. I got to find the fight. You a fighter?
Right, that's crazy.
Good. Let's fight.
Right.
So back then, I used to do that. I used to be all the way around the board. Man, Compton got some dope people. My homie Chill from Compton's Most Wanted. My man, Dogman. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's so many dope dudes.
Mm. Shout out to Dogman.
Yeah, they still just right down the surface,
like
man. But it's a good thing to be a part of, man, just to come from the Midwest, come here to L.A., be a part of that scene, and be able to saturate.
Mm.
You know, it's dope. But back on the other tip, when, you know, being young with the whole demo thing and all of that, the demo thing never really pushed off because I've been more like, I've been like really particular on business from day one because of the people like I was telling you that I was introduced to.
Yeah,
they
it's
would
not
always
a problem.
Yeah, they would always be on my head, like on what to look for and what sounds good and what ain't.
Right.
So even though I was a young dude and I was just considered quote unquote a rapper, you know, didn't have that respect at the time. People don't want to give you that respect of a musician.
Right.
I was just savvy, like no one was cracking. Like, I'm not doing that. Oh, 12-inch, and then that's all, and then I'm an OU. No, I'm not doing that. And, you know, such, okay, I get an album out, but then on this, I got to, and you got to write to my name if I do something else in another entity, but you ain't even bring nothing to the table for that entity?
Yeah.
No, I'm not doing that.
Mm.
So I done been a regular guy with the skills, I guess, that could have went somewhere else.
Right.
And just never changed into Superman, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? I kept the Clark Kent job, you know what I'm saying? I kept the Metropolis Clark, job and stuff. And then,
but your power's are inside.
Exactly, you know, but if I need to, and somebody's crossing the street,
right?
It's like, ah!
Right.
Don't tell nobody you saw that. Don't tell nobody you saw that. So it's like that.
Yeah, shout out to the chat.
Yeah, what's going on in the chat? Yeah. What we got going on in the chat?
Shout out to the chat. We're going to get back to that, man, because we're going to
I'm with it, yeah. Anybody bring any pizza rolls in the chat? What the hell? What's up?
If y'all have any questions, y'all can ask them also. Oh, I'm addicted to nothing like it. Oh, that's a song. Yeah, yeah, they got it. Yo, shout out to Dave Flores. Oh, shout out to Dave Flores, man. I want to shout him out. He's the cat that did my video.
Okay.
Did Sean tell you the idea that I have? You got to let me know about that, man, because I got a nice idea for us to do. I'm write some stuff for him.
Well, I'm with it.
Yeah, with man. So shout out to the Flores Animations.
Grandmother's Land.
Oh, thank you. He said, huh?
He did Grandmother's Land.
He did Grandmother's Land. Yeah, yeah, that's the guy. Right there, him and his son. Flores Animation, Rocket to Nebula's best album ever. Thank you. Thank you for that, bro. Thank you. So, shout out to Dave Flores is in the building. Yeah, he did great with that. So, man.
I got heavy metal and CD just. Oh, okay. So, yeah, that's what's. Okay.
Yeah, man. So, jumping right back into it.
Yeah.
How did you get on Soul Train? Did you meet Don Cornelius? There's a couple of.
It's like there's a lot of things that
started. Started. Yeah.
Was there Soul Glow involved? Did you get it? Like,
no, that's
free bag.
Did you see performances on there?
Oh yeah, all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was dope. Like I said, you being on the set of a show like that. Right.
Do they do it live?
No, it wasn't live at all. Yeah. It was just like we would meet once a month.
Yeah.
And they would like tape a month's worth of shows.
Got you.
And then you know like.
Isn't that the one where they have like the spotlight dance? Or is that a different show?
Oh, no, yeah, that's it. Okay. That's it. Yeah, well, you're talking about Scrabble board and whatnot, right?
Yeah.
Scrabble board, and they put the thing together.
I don't think she's thinking about that. She's thinking about solid gold. Yeah.
Did she go to solid?
I'm sorry. Yo, sorry.
Marilyn McCoo. Marilyn McCoo.
It's going to get funny.
That's when Arsenio Hall was comedian on Solid Gold. He's chucking back.
That was a good show, too.
That was a good show. That was a really good show.
Solid Gold was more like.
No, they didn't do that on Soul Train. Was a Scrabble board, Soul Train line, you know, the typical things like that.
Yeah.
No, but it was a great experience. Like, Don was, I got to be there kind of for the transition of two different eras, so it was kind of dope. The 80s going into the 90s era.
Dope.
When, you know, Don was kind of embracing hip hop. He was kind of slow to embrace hip hop, I'll be honest with you. And I'm glad I got to be kind of behind the scenes catalyst for that to kind of soften him up a little bit.
Right.
Because Eric, the guy who was my mentor, you know, I was able to get a little closer to Don in that sense. So whenever he wanted some street temperature or.
Was his voice really that deep?
Oh, yeah, of course. Hey, that's my man. Uncle Don.
Let's go to the store.
Uncle Don is exactly how he is.
Wow.
But anytime he wanted some street temperature for what was going on, he would ask Eric, and then Eric would ask me. And it would be like that. You know what I'm saying?
I'm trying to think of one of the dancers who passed away recently, who started with Freddie Stubbs. You know, everybody knows him as Rerun. But he started with.
Oh, he was one of like the Pop Lockers.
He was one of the original dudes. He passed away.
Frank Beard.
It was Locke. His name was what's the name of the song?
He's a Locker.
Yeah, he's a Locker. He's the cat.
He's probably one of those.
He's the one that started them.
He's probably one of those.
If y'all know, just hit me with that.
He's probably one of those. I don't know. That's way before my era. I keep it funky with you.
Yeah. He just passed away, though, but I used to.
Now, you know, one thing that I learned, which was kind of dope, and I learned that doing the thing when me and AD was doing for Don for the website, was that, remember that Tony Basil? Remember that? Remember Tony Basil? I did not know that she was like one of the original... Lockers.
Get out of here.
Yeah. We interviewed her that day. No, it's all good. We interviewed her that day and she gave us that news and I was like, oh shit, you just dropped a bomb on me. I did not know that.
Wow, that's crazy, yo.
Yeah, she was one of the original Pop Lockers. She told us that. I was like, damn, are you serious?
Wow.
She was the one that sang the Mickey song.
Oh, Ricky, you're so pretty. You so.
Her. Get out of here.
She was one of the original Lockers.
That's crazy. Yeah, that's some history. I didn't know.
If I'm not mistaken, she got some footage maybe on Soul Train or something like that. She has to have some somewhere.
Yo, y'all come on in.
She goes back to, that was just a pop song that she just happened to get put on. Because I hollered at her about that when we interviewed her. And that was an interesting thing.
It was a stupid song, but it was still popular.
Yeah, it was interesting.
Yeah.
Still timeless, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was dope, man.
Shout out Tony Benson. Yeah, she's an original. And you know what? When they have like the, you know, like the dancer kind of things, balls and stuff like that, right, she'll still come out and represent, still get in the circle.
Wow.
At her old age, she will still get in the circle and freak it out.
That's crazy.
Oh, yeah, man. She's no joke.
The Soul Train Dance Line.
Shout out Tony Benson. No, I mean, just talking about just, I'm talking about just pop, just
get out of here.
Oh, yeah, she's nice. You tripping.
I wonder if she can pop.
She is a hip hop head. You don't understand.
That's crazy, bro.
She is such a hip hop. And an OG, though, not even just a head.
She's definitely an OG.
She's one of the original lockers, so you got to get rid of that OG status.
Yeah, she's definitely an OG.
So see, that just shows you how beautiful hip hop is. It comes in.
Yep. Yeah, Rerun. He was with Shabba Doo. He's from. He's from.
It comes in all forms. You feel me?
Yeah, he's from Chicago.
Is he?
Shabba Doo.
Shabba Doo.
Yeah, he is.
Ozone to y'all. If y'all don't know, that's Ozone.
Yeah, that's Ozone.
Cats
that don't
know.
That's her. Wow.
I told you.
Crazy. She ain't get busy though.
But she does get busy, though.
No, she didn't get busy.
Yeah, not on that one. Remember that dude was in Breaking, remember? See, look.
Yeah, he battled. Yeah, I remember that.
That's her. Yeah, that's her right there.
Go ahead then, Tony.
I told you.
Yeah, it can rerun.
Me tells no lies, man. Facts jacks right here.
That's dope. So, yo, Tiger Style, you know, that's how we start. I know you got to do that on your show. I know you got to start.
Yeah, man.
Tiger Style.
I don't even know. No, but that's
got to come out to that.
That's just been the name, man, for... That's been my name for a while, man. Like, because like I said, people used to get Tony Tiger, confused and saying Tony the Tiger.
Right.
So, you know, everybody would just say Tiger Style to me when they would see me.
Tiger Style.
Just like that. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to start calling myself Tony Tiger Style then.
Dope.
We'll go with Tony Tiger Style. And it stuck.
Dope.
Now
dope.
I can't go nowhere without people just saying Tiger Style, period. Hey, Tiger Style, what's up, Tiger Style? So I just answer. That's what it is.
Tiger Style.
Dope. So you finish with... You finished with Soul Train.
Yeah.
You're moving on now.
Yeah, moving on. Yeah, I kind of get out into the hip hop world a little bit. I started going to places like Unity because I knew LA better.
Okay.
I was going to all the clubs, United Nations, Funk Jungle, everything I could get my hands on.
Nice.
Like everything that was going on in LA, I was going, man. And Lamert Circle was a big spot I used to go to on Chaos on Thursday nights, man. And that's just where Freestyle Fellowship,
the
homies Peace and these guys, and Medusa.
Medusa, you know, shout out to Medusa.
Yeah, LA natives like that. You know, I would go over there and I would just cipher with dudes, Mike and Nine and all these guys.
Mike and Nine.
Yeah, I would go over and just cipher, dude, with cats like that, you know, and they had a different style. Their style was more like, you know, soaring, flooring, styles, wild. You know, they be kind of doing like the off in the space thing. Yeah, they don't even look at you like, yo, my lyrical conceptual.
Wow.
You know, forceps, biceps. Like, I used to battle and be like, who the fuck is you looking at? Like, who the fuck? I'm over here. I used to make fun of this
you
shit.
You battled Mike and
Nine? I didn't battle Mike and Nine, but like, what I would do is I would just go to open. That's how I met AD.
He's a dope lyricist, man. Mike and Nine. Shout out to Mike and Nine.
No, that's no.
I'm asking him.
Oh, did you ever battle Priest?
Of course.
Yeah, that's what it is. Did you see how Thanos said that shit? He said that shit. He was like, of course.
Of course, man. Of course. Your beginning is sort of like mine. When you're coming up as a rapper, you have to battle. I mean, that's
it's like a fighter without a fight.
There you go.
You might be tight with the hands, but who have you knocked out?
Now, this is the footage I really want. Need to find this footage.
You know, who have you knocked out? Who have you battled? Yeah, like,
exactly.
And I can tell you, like, it got so desperate for me. This wasn't like nothing trying to be cocky, but I had times when I was younger out here that I didn't even want to let my family, my mother and them know that I was like hard up for money.
Right.
So I would hit up like the open mics. I would go down to OC. I would go to Hollywood and everywhere I would. Anytime they was talking about like it was open mic for money, rap battle.
Right.
Or you was losing that night.
Right.
Or you was losing. Because I'm coming.
Oh, yeah.
I'm coming. I'm coming to pay my rent.
You ready, man?
I'm coming to pay my rent, and that's what it is. And when
I'm trying
to say, man. Yeah, and I'm a nice guy, and I love to be very whatever, you dig, like chill. But the reason my name is Tiger is because.
Is she right there, right? And so your Genesis come with.
AD. They had a contest. They had some kind of a, what was that thing y'all had, AD? Remember you and JC was
We're
like
gonna
a,
play that.
It was like
AD.
It was an online contest, like Spitfire thing. It was where people could submit video of themselves spitting.
Okay, yeah, and I remember it was something like that, and they had like some kind of little whatever. It was a contest.
Oh,
it was for studio time. That's what it was. Okay. They had a battle, and it was for studio time, and I needed the studio time. I came down to their battle, and I won the shit.
Wow.
And I met JC, and JC introduced my man Josh Crater, shout out. And then he introduced me when he brought me to the studio. It was AD studio.
Man, shout out to JC. Shout out to for introducing you to AD, man.
Because that's the noise. He brought me to the studio because that was for the AD, studio.
You
got to
put some noise on that.
Yeah, man.
And I met AD that way because I battled for studio time and he was the guy who had the studio.
Oh, okay, okay. Wow.
And we have been friends ever since.
Wow, man.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Could you put a spin of 16 real quick? I was going to say.
I'll try. What beat you want? I don't care. Whatever.
Pre
got to rhyme with me though.
I was actually just joking.
Yeah, I don't care. I'll try, man. If God is in the room, I'm with it. Well, I try to spit it.
Because you've been around for a minute, man. And, yeah, man. And Cass got to know. You know, you've been out here doing it.
Yeah, man. See, they're catching me at 48. I wish they would have catched me at 28. But it's all good. Ah! Give me some of that J Dilla shit. Where's that Dilla shit? You know, you be coming with that. You want me to go Big B style. He like hearing me scream like my Busta Rhymes style. He want me to be like, yo, my lyrical, something the lyrical. I'm not doing all that, man. I'm not.
That shit's dope. I love that shit.
He wants me to go like that.
What you want, Jay Dilla? What?
I don't care, man. What's up? Just give me some of that swing, some black milk or something, man. You know that shit I like, man. You know what we do, man. Shout out Jay Dilla, rest in peace, man.
Oh, top, talk to him, yeah.
Come on, man. I wish I would have rocked with Dilla, man. Dilla's the best.
Is this too slow or what? You like that?
Man, you can pick it up, man. Give me some energy, man. Come on, AD. AD over here right now.
You said Jay Dilla.
This
so
is AD over here right now. No, I'm not going to get my man 80. Yeah. 80 is a beast. I'm not going to give him a hard time. He's a beast with it.
Shout out to everybody. Make sure y'all hit the subscribe button and likes.
Yeah, play that. That'll work. Fuck it. Let it bounce.
Make sure y'all hit that super chat.
It's a compilation.
If y'all got any questions, y'all want to ask our Tiger Style,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Got a lot of more stuff to get into, too. You want to spit.
I'm with it. And, yo, shout out. Hold on a second. I saw my man in the chat. I don't let people think they slide. I saw my man in the chat say some old shit about, like, yo, your man don't take a breath. Yeah, we talking, man. It's called podcast, yo. It's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to talk. And you're supposed to listen. So listen. Shh. How about that?
Yo. I mean, you don't have to spit, though. I don't mind.
I'm open to it, man. Yeah, it's like, I just try to do it if it's in the room.
Because,
No,
it's fun. I want to hear it.
It's all good, man, if it's in the room. The way I feel with that is, if it's in the room, it's like if the vibe is there.
Right, I'm with it. If it's there, so it's there. Yeah, man, it's... AD can't find a beat.
Well, he just got JD and then they come with those Stevie beats.
Because AD wants you to spit a style, he wants you to spit.
I'll let you pick it, AD. Fuck it, man. Come
yeah, AD
on.
Said, I want you to spit to this. That's what AD's good at.
He said Jay Dilla, so I was putting
it. Nah, he right. AD be trying to do it.
You know something in particular you want to do?
I'm saying we took it too long on this.
No, it don't make a difference.
Yeah, I know.
It don't make a difference. It don't make a difference.
Somebody said a million for Jay-Z.
Shout out. Oh, a million. Oh,
They
want to hear some up-tempo shit. There you go. They want to hear some up-tempo shit.
Let them pick.
So like some Just Blaze or something. You know, they want that hype. They want that battle rap, I guess.
Somebody said a Wu-Tang beat.
Oh, Wu-Tang beat. Yeah. They want that battle rap.
Shout out to Detroit.
Hey, kitty cat.
Oh, that cat right there is, you know the cat.
Yeah, man.
Did you pet him?
Yeah, always.
He let you pet him?
Of course.
Yo, make some noise. Well. He's the first cat that ever.
He always lets me pet him since back in the day.
We got to show that,
We got history.
Yeah, that's dope. When he was just a kid.
Yeah, before we got history. Yeah. I remember coming over to 80's house and he used to come up and sniff on me and shit. I know.
Somebody said better tomorrow.
He's like, it's the same dude. It's
we're
same
part
dude.
Of the game. Me and Raz. El Roar, shout out to El Roar. Somebody said Just Blaze. Shout out to Just Blaze, too.
Whoop, whoop.
Man, this is already exciting, man.
I'm just lit to be here, man.
Yeah,
this is dope,
we have to 72. Let's get up to 100.
I appreciate y'all for having me.
Man, it's
where's
it's
the skills? Oh, there you go. If you're going to go gangsta, then go skills. That's a hot beat to rap over skills. Do you? Yo, yo, yo. That's their shit.
Somebody, Chamber Dime.
I got the record actually that they had that sample on, and I heard the part where he sampled it, and that's clever. Yeah, Premiere is dope. Because that little, if you hear the record that that sample is on, it's that fast.
Yeah.
And he got this one little piece of that. Yeah. Oh, man. He's clever. Because that's, man.
Dave Flores, yo. I saw that, Oh, this is it?
Yeah.
Oh, verbal intercourse would be dope.
Oh, yeah, that's dope too.
Yeah.
Now, shout out to the beat and you don't stop. Mixing Blended though is still that hip hop. I do it to the drip drop. You be talking that, but you need to stop. Yeah. I guess I rock the party. I guess I be the one to come and shoot you up without using a shoddy. I guess I'm not the one to catch a body, but I be that one to come and kill your party. Hold up. I got more flows and you got excuses. You wanna be the bomb, but you're so defuseless. I hit you in your jaw and leave you with some toothless. With my John Wilkes Booth shit. Abraham Lincoln and leave you dead and stinking. What the fuck was you thinking? You pretty and pink and inside a caddy. You looking at me, but I'm not your daddy.
Hold
on. I'm just on some other shit.
That's it, yo. You killed it.
Hey.
That's it. That's it, man. We yo, you killed that. Yo, you said I'd knock your teeth.
Yeah.
Yo, wisdom teeth.
I'm a freestyle fanatic. I bounce like I'm Roger on a mattress. Much more bounce for the ounce. And you niggas talking loud is only just an actress. I'm nasty at this. I attack this with verbs and nouns. You talk this, but you can't last this. last a round. I do this type minute by the second by the pound. Hit you in your neck and make your shoulders spin around. Let's be the tiger style. How the do you sound? Freestyle, and I'm still spellbound like K Solo. Kill you on your own damn promo.
Not a fires.
Talking for real, no homo. Your wrist is broke. To me, you just a joke. An anti Rakim that's talking out the egg yolk. Please, but only speak when you spoke.
Yeah.
B spokes on my roller. Come through just like I be the stroller. Wheeling, dealing.
Ooh.
Tony Tiger top wheeling. I mean, I'm stallion or some shit. Lost. It's all good. Fire.
Uh-oh.
My man said fire. That's what it is. Fire. That's the old man flow. You gotta catch me on some hype.
You got AD starting. All right, AD.
AD's a real beast on them keys. Yes, don't let him fool you.
I try to let him know.
Play that Phantom of the Opera shit.
Yeah. Wow. A lot of talent up in the building.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is a dope.
Check it out. Hold up. Time to beat up one time. Homie, let it breathe. I'm $6 million. My name is not Steve. I got some shit that Ripley's believe. I come out my sleeve. Hold up.
Nice.
Hold up. I got the traction. First name Action. Last name Jackson. Shoot more threes retired than John Paxson. Bring it to your crew to a matter of a fraction. Hold up your void. Bore out your space invade with your asteroid. What you really want to do? You're non-congruent. Talking to a dude, but you don't really speak it fluent. Talking about your freestyle. You couldn't last a green mile. Please, I can smack off the Davis smile. Davis smile. It doesn't really matter, dog.
Some noise for this.
Smile. Hey.
Yo.
Freestyle fanatic. Every time I breathe is just another classic.
Oh.
You touch a microphone, it gets Jurassic. You get too close, you get your ass kicked. Leave your ass up in a basket. Tisk get a task it before you ask it. Nasty with the verbs and calisthenics. I leave your name not knowing your name inside a clinic. If you got a crew better than you, you best send it. I leave you backwards, triangleized and twisted.
Ooh.
The tiger style shit listed is you. Trying to mess with me, I found a residue. Smoking to the residue. Hey, regurgitate your bone marrow, suck it out of just a chew.
Oh.
Who you talking to?
Just come on, yo.
That's that old battle shit in there. I wouldn't let it
go. Love it. That was
dope,
fire.
That's what it is. Old man flow.
Fire, yo. Fire. Come on, man. Make some noise, man. Make some noise. Tiger style, yo. Yo. That was hard, bro.
That was hard. Thank you for the words. Thank you.
So how do cats get, you know, get your music or follow you, you know.
Yo, I got stuff out there, man. Like, you can go to Bandcamp. You can check out the little Vent EP thing that I put out, like, you know, a couple months ago. You can check that out, Vent. One of the songs on there that's pretty chill is Good Night. That's a song I really, really love. I'd like to do a video for it. The Vent project is like, I just do projects as I feel it now. You know, you get older.
Let's shout
it's
out.
It's not like you're trying to chase it. You dig?
Shout out to, oh yeah, pardon me. You know?
No, it's all good.
This is what we do. We
it's all good.
All right, shout out to Oli, what's that, Matic? Yo, put it right down. What up,
Tiger KP? Style Kung Fu right come. There. That's what's up. Kung you hear that? That's what's up, Sacred Heart. You know it.
Thank you. All right.
You know it.
With the catalog. Hearing the ancient astronauts with the track. Oh, yeah. Shout out to Jacka, man.
Shout out.
Yep. Yeah, you came through. And shout out to Woo Beats also. Woo Beats. All right.
Shout out. Yeah. That's what's up. No.
Hit that super chat. Good looking.
Hey, yo, respect y'all. Hey, yo, I appreciate y'all for appreciating me. Thanks so much, man. It's just if it's in the room. Thanks.
You know what is good? It's good to hear lyrics again. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
With Cassie, you're a rapper. And you MC. I'm a MC.
Thanks, man.
And hearing lyrics like that, it just is good. You know what I mean? It's good for hip hop. It's motivation. Yeah.
It's the energy, man. Like, and I think, like, this is a good time, I think, man, like, for our particular generation. Like, you know, we're in the same age bracket.
Yeah, right.
It's like, you know, we the Chris's now. We the Canes. We the Cool J's. It's time for us to kind of pay some of these elements forward. You know what I mean? Like, just the teachings. This is what it is. The next generation take it. The next generation take it.
That's
put their stamp on it. And so on and so forth.
That's
you know?
Real. That's real,
it's like,
bro.
We have our times. You know, everybody had their eras.
Yeah.
And I look at it like being like a retired superhero. You dig it? Like, you know, like the Incredibles? Remember when they outlawed being a superhero on the Incredibles and you couldn't be a superhero? So you had to walk around and just be regular.
Yeah.
You know, and then you got in trouble if you did superhero shit. That's what it feels like now. So I feel like I'm a retired superhero just trying to walk around and do super regular shit without getting in trouble. do too much hip-hop stuff, I'll get in trouble. Yeah, I feel like
you gotta
that.
You got to be on the low, right?
I feel like that, yeah.
Shout out to Golden Cougar.
Okay.
This ain't right? Yeah, Golden Cougar from Toronto.
Yeah.
Probably the First Nation. Shout out to the First Nation out there, man.
Shout out.
I've been getting a lot of love. Oh, Dave. Yeah, man.
Thank you, man. Hey, I appreciate y'all, man. That's what's up.
That's a dope name for a track. You said Crouching Tiger, Killer Dragon.
Ooh.
That's the song right there.
I like
bro.
It. I like
put
it.
That
I
in
like
there.
It.
Was dope.
I like it.
That's dope. That's the song.
Yeah, if y'all want to check it out, man, I got music out there like in different places. I got a single called Riding Through that's actually out right now on Apple Music, but I'm going as my regular name. So
right.
I'm going as Tony Lowry. My last name is Lowry, like Mike Lowry, like Bad Boys.
You're right.
Yeah, but my real name is Lowry. So I'm going as Tony Lowry. You can go on there. You can check out my joint Riding Through, you know, with an O, Lowery. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you can check out my little EP Vent out there as well. You know, it's got a few songs on there. Some of the songs on that release, though, are not correct. So I got to kind of correct the release and put some of the other songs up there.
Right.
But you can go to Bandcamp. Check me out as Tony Tiger Style. Either look for Tony Tiger Style or look for Tony Lowry. Either way, my stuff will come up.
Nice. Y'all heard that?
Find me. Yep.
Get up.
Check it out, man. I appreciate it, man.
Man.
You know, check me out, man. My thing is I do fitness, man. Now, I mean, that was the other thing is I do music.
Yeah.
But now, you know, over the years, since like 2012, I started a fitness brand called Live at 1000 Fitness.
Nice.
I started out training people via video because I was training some of my friends that were in the music game.
Right.
And, you know, some of them in Germany, some people here. So I would train them via video, just like do stuff like WhatsApp and Skype, feel me? And then it just became a thing.
Wow.
And I was like, you know what? I should start doing this like regularly and get people, boom, boom, boom.
Right.
But I got to go in with a mission. So my mission was like, yo, I want to target people that I know that really are kind of like, ugh, when it comes to personal fitness and all of that. They're like, eh, it seems like something extra, taboo. I want to make it more user-friendly because we such at a rate. You know, we're so at risk for like chronic disease and stuff like that. We don't even know it.
Just
off of
that,
basic stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And if you don't know this information, somebody's not going to just tap you on the shoulder. Hey, let me show you how to save your life. You know, they're not going to do that. So I'm like, yeah, I do hip hop and I got a voice in that.
Right.
Let me take that voice and then put it into this.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And see if I can save some lives and make people healthy. So I started that fitness brand and started training people like that. And it's been growing pretty well. It's going pretty good. And then, you know, through that same umbrella, I'm able to still use my entertainment talents, you know, and like I said, put that cape on every now and then.
Yeah. What is it? Is it more of the diet or is it, you know,
well, it's everything.
Motivation?
So I'm a fitness trainer. So I help you with physical performance, but now I'm also learning how to coach you with nutrition. So now, not telling you what to eat, but just telling you better ways to eat and promoting you, like, you know, show you how to, like, make better choices, you know, based off of what's best for you.
Right.
You know, versus just, like, what you hear the homie say that this worked for him, and then he did the Atkins diet, and this dude said don't eat no bread for 52 weeks, right. Whatever.
Like, is that real?
You know, no, it's a lot of myths out there. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I try to debunk it. And it's like when people come to me, like, I don't work for a lot of the corporate gyms. You know, and I ain't going to have to name them. You know who they are.
Right, yeah.
I don't work for them. And where I had a problem... seriously. Nah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
got all these different ones, right?
Yeah.
Where I had a problem was, how do I sell you something just to get money on the board, right? That I know you don't fully need. It's not, you don't need all of that.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So I got to eat off of this, but then, you know what I'm saying? That's not cool. Like, that's where I get a little, it's hard.
Right.
So I want to give you what's right for you. I don't want to eye gouge you and all that kind of stuff. So that's why I started doing it for myself.
Shout out to Lincoln, too. He's
a trainer. I started doing it myself, you feel me?
And that's you right there?
Yeah, that's me. That's me and one of my clients, Tanya, right there. We working on some boxing. And what's so crazy is this is her at the beginning. So this is her at the beginning. And you should pull up the one when she's, you should pull up the other one. There's another one after this where she's a lot more trained. Yeah, you can see.
Shout out to Karina, man. We got a boxer that be around.
Oh, what?
Yeah. Shout out to Karina. I know she probably watching tonight.
Yeah. I come from that background, like where we from in the Midwest. You know, it's a big thing. Shout out Pena Boxing. Now, this is her right here after us training for like, I don't know how many, it was probably like 2 or 3 months in. Now, you see she's a lot leaner. She's a lot leaner.
Wow.
Look, this is her after. Now, watch how she hits now. Watch this. This is crazy. And she has a resistance band on her legs, too. So she can't... Yeah, she has resistance on her legs, and she can't move when we're doing this. This is so dope. I was so impressed by her. I was like, what?
Okay.
Watch how quick she shows a three. Woo!
Uh-huh. Wow, that's great, man. That's great. Oh, okay. Somebody said, watch this KO. Now, I'll be watching.
It's all right.
Watch this KO. Nice.
Yeah, she's a beast, man.
Mm-hmm.
And this is just like consistent training, man. So I always teach my athletes, man, to get like this athletic mindset as if like they're a pro athlete.
That's dope.
And this is what they do for a living.
Right.
You ain't just training. This is part of your mindset is you're a pro athlete.
Right.
So if you don't never turn that switch off, you're going to act accordingly, right? You're going to eat a certain way. You know what I'm saying? You're going to act a certain way.
Right.
So
if here is dropping knowledge.
That's the whole thing. Yeah,
right,
man.
That's dope, bro.
So I'll be trying to show them that. Trying to show them in every aspect, man, of what it is. And it's real in the field. It's all coming from the heart. It's what it is. So Live With A Thousand is the brand. You know, you can check me out on the gram and all of that junk while you following all them copycats. Go over to @live@1000fitness and add a brother. Pay attention.
This is dope.
Check your brother out on YouTube or something. You already know what to do. Stop playing.
Man, we had a dope interview yesterday, bro.
Come on, man. We had a lit interview yesterday. Super lit.
Yeah, it was lit.
This guy had me rolling.
You don't even
understand. I asked him this question, y'all. I said, one album, one artist you can listen to all day. Y'all know what he said? Milli Vanilli. That's the kind of shit he says. He was fucking with me, but he said Milli Vanilli off top. Just that shit was hilarious. That's great. That's why I love this guy. I love this guy off top for saying that answer. No, he later came back with it, said Minnie Riperton and said Sade, but it was just hilarious off top. He was just like, no expression.
Yeah.
Milli Vanilli. Yeah. I was like, what the fuck? And that was great.
I said Mike.
That was great. And then we were talking about actually Michael Prince. That was dope.
But that's a big battle. Everybody, what if they did a song together? You know what I mean?
That would have been brilliant, right?
Mike.
And you know what? What was crazy is,
and
look,
Prince doing
a
song.
There's a story behind that, though, for real, that they were actually supposed to do a song together.
For real?
And Prince didn't show to the studio.
Prince would have did that. He's a little bit more mean.
I think Prince was a little bit more mean than Mike. There's a story about that. There is. I read that story. I was like, what? Because I thought the same thing. I was like, what would happen if they got in there? That'd be so beautiful. Why didn't they ever do that? Yeah. So
Whitney
crazy,
Houston.
Crazy. Let's see what's going on in the chat. Who's saying something like that?
Yes, Whitney Houston.
These folks, man.
Shout out to Hugo Rivera. Yo, Mr. Reed, where can I get that shirt?
Thank you, Sacred Heart. Sacred Heart. Oh, you're a good person, Titus. That's nice. Thank you.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Peace to that.
The shirt, you can get this shirt from let me see, Hip Hop. I'm slipping with this. My man, call get with my man Sean. You know what I'm saying? Hip Hop Junkies is the one who did the shirt. So you can get that. Look them up and on the Instagram. Hip Hop Junkies.
That shit is dope, though. Lyrics, yeah. Lyrics matter. No mumble rap. Explicit content.
Yeah.
No mumble rap. I'm a writer. Should I be platinum now? I should be platinum.
Yeah.
I should be platinum. Y'all go get that. Go get that right now. Download that. That's that new joint right there. Drop that.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's what it is.
It's this type of. Oh no.
Uh oh.
Call it how it is.
Tell how it is. Cody and Cray.
Oh yeah, I saw this. The dancing, right?
Hey, let's get it. What we doing? Oh. Oh shit. I love it. Oh my god.
She get down.
Hey, yo. Hey,
put her on Soul Train.
Get it, Karen. Hey,
yo,
get
it, you know, Karen. I'm laughing at
Karen's living it. Hey, living it.
But look at the one way in the back, though.
Yeah. My man is way doing, he doing UGL moves and shit. What was he doing? He was going up and under the forearms.
Yeah.
He was doing, yeah, that. What was the up and the forearms? Was,
yeah,
switching
I know.
The forearms. Like, hey, we were switching forearms and shit was up and under.
Yeah,
up,
he was
under, up and under.
Trying to do a crunk. Yeah, exactly.
I'm crumping.
That's some crazy choreography.
If I go
right
up
there.
And under, yeah, then I'm crumping.
You still follow dances?
Yeah, sometimes, man. No. We didn't find the Soul Train clip. She determined to get the Soul Train clip. That's classic. I can tell you which one it is. You know what? You can look up Guy in the Soul Train line, and that should bring up one. There you go. Look up Guy. I remember that. I did that.
Yeah.
There was a Guy Soul Train line, and I was in one of those, and I can't remember which one it was.
That's got to be you right there.
I can't remember which one it was, but I do remember that. And then there was another one.
Prove me.
It had to be in.
Baby.
You got to let me know.
It couldn't have been that late because I wasn't there. No, that's 73, bro. I wasn't there in 73, dog. Come on now. How old am I supposed to be?
What do I Google?
It was like 1990 something. I want to say Guy Soul Train line. Just go Guy Soul Train line.
Peace to the gods. Black Rain is in the house. Shout out to y'all.
Wait a minute. It might be one of those. Is it one of those? I think I know it when I see it, but I can't remember. It's been a while.
We got to clip it out and put it in your portfolio. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm kind of old.
I'll help you out. We'll find it. We'll put it on your website.
Oh, there. Wait. I think that's it right there. 91. Try to Tony. That's a good laugh. I think I'm in that one.
Oh.
Oh, no. The one you were just above. Go back. Oh, that was it. That one. That guy right there. That one. I'm in that one. No, I'm not. No, I'm in that one, though. Watch this. Watch this shit. You're going to see my skinny BBD version, ladies and gentlemen. I'm still sexy, though. Watch this.
Yeah.
Got moves.
Yeah, okay, best, yeah.
Laugh at me all you want to. Just trying to tell you at the time.
Who is this, though?
At the time, I was cool. That's the homegirl, Barbara. My man, Alfie Lewis, right there. That's one of the coldest dancers on the West Coast to me.
Get out
Shout
of here.
Out Alfie. That's my guy, man. Yeah, Alfie Lewis is cold.
Yeah.
Cold. Everybody's
dope. He getting it in, yo.
He's cold. He's a beast. He's a beast. The homegirl, Sean. These are all my brothers and sisters. Shout out.
Oh, man.
No, that's Sean. Man. Shout out to all my Soul Train.
Oh, she's doing
family.
The Marty Bar.
Yeah.
This is the Marty Bar right there. Oh,
here he come. Oh, that's the homie Leland. I'm coming up in about two people.
Hold on. Take that girl back.
I'm the next guy.
Yo, she was fine as hell.
Hold on. Bring that girl back. You got to bring that girl back.
Y'all riffing on Sean, huh? Y'all riffing on Sean.
I thought that was Michelle Rodriguez right there.
No, that's Sean. She's a black
girl. Fast and Furious.
That's funny.
Yo, this move that she did, that's the body bar. There's something happened wrong right here. It's like
that's the choreography, Priest.
She did that little step move, though, didn't she? When she stepped off?
Let's go. She's sexy.
This the homie Leland right here.
All right.
I'm after Leland. I got on that orange and green jacket. You see me getting loaded? There.
Yeah.
This the homegirl, Tiffany. Shout out, Tiffany Lee. Yeah,
hey.
She's actually she's a trainer in her own right as well too.
That's crazy.
She's one of them.
That would make sense.
Look, here comes your boy. You ready for it? Here we
go.
Hey, are you the flyest one? Yeah.
There you go.
Okay,
that's me. Hey! Don't tell me nothing about my skill.
Oh man,
don't tell me nothing about my skill.
You killed that.
That was me.
Yeah, you was the flyest one up there.
I told you. That's
you had the jacket. You had the jacket on. Yeah, you was in there. Yeah, you killed it.
There you go. That's man. Your boy. Wow.
Make some noise for him, man. We got to make some noise for him. Make some noise for him, yo. He did that. Killed that. That was dope.
I'm a man of my word. No, those were some good days,
man.
Those were some good days, man. I'm serious. Like, around there, man, I met so many people. Cool J. I met Bobby Brown. Like, one time, even on the show, like, Don let me ask an interview question. He let the audience ask a couple questions.
Oh, he was in there.
And Bobby Brown was there, and he let me ask him a question about where I could send my demo.
No. Oh, yeah?
Yeah, seriously. Like, yeah, it's out there as well somewhere, too. I don't know the link to that one, so we yeah. I don't know if I can find it.
Hey, you got a website that's being under construction right now, right?
Yes, yes. We got TonyLowry.com on the way. It's coming at you.
And everything going to be on there.
Everything's going to be. So you'll be able to hear my music stuff. You'll be able to see my fitness. It's a one-stop shop for your guy.
And the Soul Train clips.
Finally. No. Yeah. We won't add a Soul Train clips.
We're going to put everything.
There will be no Soul Train clips, ladies and gentlemen. I just want you to know.
That's amazing right there.
That shit will be deleted tonight when I get home. Just want to let you know that right now. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
Yo, we had 74. Let's get it up to 100, yo. AD.
Yeah, man. Y'all need to wake up your cousins or somebody. Tell them we're giving away free corn chips or something. Yeah.
Shout out to Park Hammer. Good looking, man. Michael, the question he wants to ask is, Prince or Michael, what's all y'all fave song from each?
Oh, that was funny, because that's one of my top 20 questions on there. The Prince of Michael.
Yeah, that was. Yeah.
You know what? For me on that question, there's a lot. Now, let's start with Prince. Prince, oh my gosh. Which stage of Prince do you want to go to, though? All right, because you got a lot. So let's go back to Dirty Mind. We want to go back to that far? Ooh, wee. There's a lot. But let's just start it like, let's just start naming them off. Erotic City. Girls and Boys, The Ballad of Dorothy Parker. Ooh, it was 25th.
Yeah,
there's that Miss Kathleen. Oh man, that's my shit. Starfish and Coffee. Mountains by Prince. Come on, man.
You got a bunch.
Oh my gosh, there's so many.
What about what?
Wait a minute. Let me stop, because people gonna slap me. I'm black. Adore by Prince.
That's Adore. That's what I said.
My favorite Prince song is Get Off.
Yeah. Get off. Yes. Get off.
Well, that's
22 positions in a one night stand.
Yeah, exactly.
Where's that guy? Where's that guy at right now?
22 positions in a one night stand.
That's a whack.
23. I'm sorry, I left out a position. She made sure I got that position, though. She was like, it's 23.
You can't come out there.
23 like Jordan. You left out his position.
Get off.
Get it off.
I'm like, don't be messing up my
song. Yeah.
I was going to answer the Adorn, because there's no answer for that.
Which one?
Adorn for Prince?
Yeah.
There's actually no answer for that, because you hear but I got one thing that Mike did that was crazy. He sung "Want to Be Started Something"
in
a high pitched voice the entire song.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was kind of crazy. Oh, that's hard to do.
Of course. Want to be started. Of course. Now you go with Michael. You got so many songs. Let's start.
Is that your favorite?
Shout out to Roy Rooks.
Is that one of your favorites?
That's one I would. If I was, we're not comparing them, right?
No.
Okay. But that's one that he just really well. Human Nature.
Human Nature.
But
looking out.
Yeah, that was crazy.
I'm gonna take a breath. That's long.
Looking out.
Yeah,
shout
out.
Across the window.
That's some shit.
Shout out to Roy Rooks, man. Thank you for your donation, $5. He said, what's your favorite Eddie Murphy song?
Eddie Murphy
that's
song?
Hilarious.
Oh my
that's
God.
That's hilarious. The one with
favorite Eddie Murphy song.
She just party all the time, party all the time.
The one with Rick James. You got to go Rick James on that one, man.
Yeah, Rick James.
Rick James.
The one with Mike was, what was that one? When he was in the clouds?
Which one was that one? Oh, What's Up With You? What's up with you? That's all I remember. What's up? I don't even remember no lyrics. I just remember the chorus.
I'm with you on that. James Brown.
I just remember Mike posing and shit. What's up? I'm like, what the fuck is the song about? But no,
Wow, that's deep. Michael Jackson had a death anniversary. He passed away today.
So is it today?
It's today.
Michael Jackson.
Oh, wow. Yes, that's deep. Crazy, rest in peace to the king.
Yo, that's crazy, man. That's crazy. Now, Thanks for pointing that out to us, Stub Rock.
One of my favorite renditions by Mike, to be honest with you, is not none of his adult shit. Yeah. One of my favorite renditions Mike has ever done was Who's Loving You?
Definitely.
as a kid. That is the live performance of him doing that.
Yeah, that's hard. That's hard.
The song
with
you. Woo! Has like the Hesem of his music mixed in, where you were wearing his wig.
Uh oh.
What?
Where you were looking like Michael on the cover. What was the song?
That's called Unknown Mike.
Unknown Mike. Yeah, that's funny.
The song.
Unknown
Mike.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if you heard that yet.
No, I have not. No, I have not. I'm very much in the hole these days. I just be in the house.
Yeah.
I love it. I love the picture, though. Yeah. Can you please show that picture? Can they see that picture? That's hilarious.
Yeah.
That shit there.
What up?
Yeah.
Somebody coming?
I know Mike.
I like this way you got that filter, though, on that truck, though. That's,
oh, yeah. Thank you, brother. Good. Oh, yeah.
Greatness to sages of all ages. Playlist, liquid swords, we rhyme basic.
Yeah.
Time ancient, climbed out of a spaceship. Rhyme sacred, planets with black faces. The sky traces was planted in the old ages. Unknown places, catacombs left paintings. Cold cases of black mummies in foreign countries. The quiet singing I used to join
here ain't on Sunday.
But ooh, all the rebels wanted was money. True. My cousin Kevin wanted the honeys. Funny. Spark, moon, tone, linear, sunny. The dark, goons, New York City was hungry. Late 70s, fire skates with elegies.
But I love you, man. You raised me.
Oh.
Got to acknowledge
who
that.
Who said that? Which one?
Brian, right there. Brian Smith. Shout out, Brian.
Shout out, Brian. Shout out to Brian Smith, man. I'm sorry. I'm drunk. But I love you. Man, you raised me, man. Queen's Craft is in the house. Brian, thank you for that, man. Yo, this is what we do the music for,
yeah,
bro.
That's what's
we
up.
Put it.
Oh, and Rainbow Children. He said, yeah, that's right. He said.
I was about to say that's
Rainbow
a
Rainbow Children album.
That's who's that? Prince.
Prince, yeah.
Man, I don't even know. I can't keep up with Prince, man.
Yeah.
Did he have more? Who had more albums? Would it be Mike? Because he was younger.
That'd be hard. That probably
Jackson 5? Yeah, he started before them.
Probably. That's a good question.
It would be Mike.
I don't know. That would be kind of hard.
Well,
I don't know about that.
Who have? That's asked him. I would say
Prince probably has more stuff.
Yeah, you might be right. Because Mike was a solo.
Yeah, and he's one of those mad musicians. When you're a mad musician, you got a bunch of skeletons just sitting somewhere that you know you probably didn't even finish. That sounds like songs.
Yeah.
They just don't sound like songs to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I got Prince on that. He probably got a lot of stuff we don't ever hear.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Well, I did. I use Prince. I used Prince on the new album.
Mm.
Reverse the song. Yeah. Shout out to Tech Projects.
Mm.
But you would never know that's Dollar Nikki backwards, I believe. One of those songs. I know it was a famous.
Dollar Nikki is a joint, too.
Yeah. So Projects, that's a print. So I got both of them on there.
See, that's creative shit right there. Dude, backwards. Did you see? He said backwards.
Yeah.
See, who thinks of shit like that?
Is it Dollar Nikki? Oh, yeah, it's one of them.
Dollar Nikki's dope.
Yeah.
That's a great one. That's one of my favorites.
Masturbating with a magazine. That's the joint.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man.
Shout out.
How we doing out there in the chat, man? Everybody, we still good?
I got to listen. Somebody said, yeah, I got to listen to Rainbow Children. I never heard that one.
Yeah, he's got some shit.
Because
he has a lot of stuff that he produced on his MPG, and he had a lot of stuff he produced on his own site.
Was he just a symbol?
Was he just a symbol at the time?
Yeah.
I think it was a Prince album.
How you say
that?
I think name?
It was after he came back to the name.
Yeah, how you have
unpronounceable
a name?
Symbol?
He's deep, man.
The unpronounceable symbol.
Yeah. Well, you can't pronounce it.
For,
huh?
That's the dude.
The management or whatever, or the label?
Yeah, Prince is incredible.
Yeah, I'd love to have a conversation with both. I'd love to have a conversation with both, but I would love to
see
Prince in the studio.
Shout out to Pink Floyd. Oh, yeah, definitely.
That'd be dope to see him working. Yeah, that'd be dope.
No doubt. John King, I play 60 triangles. Did you get a chance to hear Rocket to Nebula?
I heard some of it, but not all of it.
Yeah.
I got it at the crib. I'm just vibing.
No doubt. Yo, man, shout out to everybody that's coming out there. Knife Prince.
Yo, your principal. Beat selection, man, just to give you a shout out, man, your beat selection is good fits, man. You have some good fits that right where you coming in on the tracks, man, like, just as an architect, man, I like salute you on that. You have some good beat fits, man.
Yeah,
you pick them good.
Thank you, bro.
Because like some of the beats you pick, I'd be like, damn, I wouldn't have picked that. I wouldn't have picked that beat, but damn, it fits.
It's totally your fit.
Like you make it work.
Yep. Well, it was a vibe.
That's what I'm saying. You make the vibe work. That's dope. I like that.
Thanks. Yo, so yeah, man. So where we are, man. I know you got some more. You got some more stuff. And we gotta get
on the hip hop. Okay, well, on the hip hop tip, just on the hip hop tip, my evolution and like more people out here on the West Coast, know me for Long Beach.
Wow, okay.
Repping Long Beach.
Shout out to Christ Apostle. You know him?
No, I'm sorry, I don't.
Yeah. And what about Monk? My man Monk, that's who he be out here.
Probably if a lot of these cats I probably would know by Facebook. They may know me.
Right.
I just don't. I'm kind of community like that where like I just, you know, I give out pounds and I just see people, I just spread love, but I don't, you know, I know a lot of people by their faces.
Right.
And stuff. And more, like I said, more people know me by name than I can remember theirs. You
that's
know what
real,
I'm
that's real.
And so, you know, I could just be in Long Beach and people like Tiger Style, yo, what's up, babe? I mean, Tiger I even know style. Who it is, and y'all give you a hug, give you love, you know, that's just what it is.
Somebody asked me, oh, we have to do this for him. What? Somebody asked me, John King said, who the hell is Bob Ross? You don't know who Bob Ross is? Oh man, huh?
No,
what did you ask?
Bob Ross. Ross, yes.
Of course, the first white guy with an afro.
Trees. Happy Little Trees.
Yeah, yeah.
Happy Little Trees. We're going to
play we're playing Bob Ross for you, man.
We're going to put a little touch of a pink right there. That's a little happy little spot right there. That's what we're going to do.
I want to see him do that with cocaine. Doing a little bit of cocaine.
It's going to take a little line right here, a little line. I'm just going to put this up in my nose. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice right there.
Load up my Mac 11 and I'm going to go kill it.
Just touching.
No, we're just going to touch it right there. We're just going to go down to those mountains. These are nice mountains. These mountains are up here in the sky and they're not bothering anybody.
Man. He's the best. Yeah. Yeah, Bob.
These are nice little mountains right here. Here.
This is the type of vibe that I had for the album. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, I named the song Bob Ross because it was like, it was a whole vibe of just happy trees, you know.
Oh, there you go. Spontaneous creation.
Yeah.
I like that.
Trees. Yeah, yeah.
Huh? I like that.
Yeah, yeah. We got the Bob Ross. He said, "Who the hell?" So you got Bob Ross now, man. You got to check him out, man. He's the look his afro. He's the first white guy with an afro. Yeah, and you know somebody told me
what?
Don't.
If Bob Ross was interracial, he's black.
But. No, he was. He was like a Navy SEAL.
He was a Navy SEAL.
Yeah.
No, I don't put that past it. I don't put that past it.
It's crazy.
I don't put that past it because, you know, because after you a Navy SEAL, all you want to do is paint happy trees. Just the fuck you want to do is paint happy trees.
Right.
The last thing you do not want confrontation at all. I bet you Bob Ross will snap off in your
shout
ass,
out to
though.
Desi, man. Shout out to Desi.
That was just going to say, I was just going to make that same connection. You hear what she said? She said it kind of reminds you of like a Mr. Rogers vibe, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's my two dudes.
That's the same
those two,
shit.
I want to see those two.
Exactly.
Who you think is cooler, Bob Ross or Mr. Rogers?
No, see, let me show you how I think. I want to see him in a cage match. I want to see him fucking snap
best.
Off.
That's the
and
best.
I want to see Mr. Rogers and that's Bob Ross best. Be ready to kick each other's ass, pissed off because one of them cut off the other one when they was trying to get a parking spot. Motherfucker, what? Do you know who I am? I'm Bob Ross. I paint happy trees, bitch.
Hold up.
Mr. Rogers be like, I know your kids, motherfucker.
Yeah.
I know your kids.
Yeah, you got it. Yes, that's it.
Picasso against Bob Ross. That's Picasso.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the number one thing. No, that's you're right. That's Picasso.
I'm gonna take a bite of my apple on that note. All right.
Yo, he's the smoothest. Yo, he was. Don't believe in this. Bob Ross' smoothness was almost like a. Or Smokey Robinson. Who's the coolest cats in the world? Like Smokey Robinson.
No, nobody's cooler than Smokey.
Yeah, Smokey. And that coolness. And
Smokey is the only dude I know that can sing and burn three calories.
He's the coolest. He's the
three
coolest.
Calories. Yeah, he'll burn three calories. He's
the coolest.
You know, he load up like he gonna say some shit. Like he gonna scream. Everybody in that era was screaming and James Brown and Smokey was cool as hell, looking at everybody with his green eyes. He whining and shit, getting all up on the mic. Have all the ladies after the show. Nah, nobody's that smooth. Except for Billy D. Williams. Except for Billy D. Williams.
Now you talking about smooth. That's like
Colt 45.
Yeah, he's like a tall.
Come on, don't let the smooth taste fool you. Where you think that came from?
He's definitely top shelf smooth.
Come on.
Smoothness. Hey man, Smokey. I'm trying to think of what's the dude who made the lowdown?
Look at Billy D. Look, Billy D.
Yeah, that's too cool. That's too cool.
You see, I got this shit parted to the side.
Yes, dang,
that was trendsetting.
I should have used Billy
D. It wasn't
D for
a mullet.
Album.
That's not a mullet.
Yeah, it's smooth, right?
That's a shag in the beginning. That was a beginner shag.
Yeah, you're
that
right.
It didn't hit the shoulders.
You're right. Yeah,
it didn't hit the shoulders, but it wasn't a taper either.
Yeah.
So, look, a beginner shag. He had that beginner shag, and he made it work. That's just how fly he was.
Somebody said show the inside of the cover. The rock. I will soon. I don't have it. I don't have it on me. I don't even have my own album, man. Yeah.
You know, when I'm defending about
Yeah, it was funny. Hold up, I'll try to.
You brought up some funny shit on the show yesterday.
Yeah, that's the best. The ghost. Martin, show
oh my gosh, man. As far as TV shows, man, you gotta love season one Fresh Prince. Season one, season two Fresh Prince.
Those two, that's why they did movies yeah. together.
Season one, season two Fresh Prince, yeah. And then the first couple of seasons yeah. of Martin.
Yeah. Before Gina effed it all up.
But I'm telling you, Martin,
yeah.
when he does the Kung Fu dude.
Yeah. It's the best. The best,
nobody man. Did caricatures better than that dude, man. That dude killed it. Kenji, like when he was like, yo, man, I'm gonna give you my money. Give you your money. Look. Yeah.
Look how he walked in by him.
Kenji. This is my shit. This never servant. Gets old. Yeah. Kid, for you to meet me. Show your kids this. Please show yes. your kids this so they have a sense of humor in the next 10 years.
Yes. And this is my obedient servant. He called him obedient.
Look, obedient. Look, my watch obedient. This.
I think it's time for you to get my check, man. Learning from the master is your pay, punk. You get in line. You get hurt. Move on, huh?
Yo, me and Ghost. So, yo,
he said, get in line then, huh?
Okay. I studied under Bruce Lee.
Hey, Ghost used this for his album, this part right here, right?
Yeah, he was on the second floor, and I was on the first.
I studied under Bruce Lee. I was on the first floor, he's on the second floor.
That would be told here this evening.
He man, telling them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would teach you the fine arts of self-defense.
Self-defense,
man,
self.
I really need the money.
Greatest.
Silent. Huh?
The other day I was running in follow exercise man, while this man to some woo.
How to execute
the aftermath
moves.
Included
power. Look at him. Look at him.
Second World of Walter Reed.
And render your opponent powerless. What? And at your mercy.
He's
as I
the
will
best.
Attack. Disable. My obedience.
Nobody's better.
Nobody's better at how this. Many kung fu cats you knew and in the hood, man? Yo, that yo. Was like that, yo.
He really captured it, dude.
Yeah. Yo, you used to see some, it was always one dude, weird dude.
Yeah, he was in the military
shoes.
Or something. He used to be in the military, then he opened up a kung fu dojo.
Exactly.
He came back,
that's why he
came
the best.
Back feeling like he was Jim Brown or somebody. Exactly. You know what I mean? He was like, yeah.
Yep.
I'm Fred Hammer in this bitch.
Yep. Jim Kelly.
Yeah, Jim Kelly. Yep. Yeah, I'm Jim Kelly.
Man, it's crazy, yo. Yeah, he's the best. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
So, we diet and you said diet, but it's all of it, right?
Oh, you're talking about as far as the fitness.
Yeah, the fitness and stuff like
on
that.
On the fitness stuff. We're just going back on the fitness stuff. Like I said, I try like to show people, like I was telling you before we stopped, is I just try to show people like the athletic mindset, fam. Like,
right.
You know, like if you're going at it, athletics and you're doing training.
Right.
The first thing I think is to get the mind right. You know, before you even
that's the problem. Yeah,
before
yeah,
you even get into the gym and getting all of that and trying to chase the carrot and all of that, get your mind right.
That's right.
Think of yourself as an athlete. If you think of yourself as an athlete, you're going to treat your body like an athlete. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
So like the way athletes do it, they're pros. They got to eat on schedule.
Yeah.
They got to sleep. You know, they got to do certain things. Yeah, they got to have a certain discipline, right, to the regimen. Yep. So I try to instill those kind of principles in the people that I train. And it makes them a lot more empowered, I think, to go at it. Like with this mindset that they can't really turn the switch off, per se. You know, there's still this dude. You know, there's still this chick, you know, underneath that is athlete that's in training.
Yeah. And, that's a good way to attack it, too, the brain.
And then the
man.
Balance is not just going in there and moving, a workload from point A to point B, you know, just working out, per se. It's knowing the balance between nutrition, dietary intake, knowing how to actually, you know, stack your meals right so you're not getting too much of one thing,
right?
You know, too less of another.
Right.
And then knowing how to incorporate that with giving your body time to recover and repair and, like, process all of this shit. You know what I mean? And I term that as my big three, you know, the activity, the nutrition, and the recovery. That's the big three I always try to teach people.
All right, that's dope.
And once you get those big three into play and balance, it starts making more sense.
Right.
You know, and then all the it's like the Matrix when the bullets stop and you're like, oh, okay, now I get it.
Yeah, yeah, that's that part.
It's that kind of clarity. Yeah.
He was the Matrix. He became the Matrix at that point.
You did?
Yeah, I love that.
So that's it. I try to really, and it's not, a lot of people got all these myths in their head and it sucks, man, because you got all this poor media out there that people got all these myths in their head. I got to take a shitload of protein. I got to do this. I can't eat carbohydrates. I can't, you know, I got to be carb, you know, I got to have no carbs in my diet. Do you understand? Let me just drop a jewel on you that carbohydrates is your energy source.
Yeah, keep it going. I got it.
For sure. Sure. Go ahead. Carbohydrates is your energy source. You know what I'm saying? So, like, if you're feeling like your energy is low and all of that, it's probably because you following a leader too much. You're doing a diet that doesn't work for your type of body. You know what I mean? You're taking in calories. I mean, you're taking in carbohydrates at a very high amount, and you're not burning them off efficiently. So then, like, if you just put it in the context of like this, man, y'all, like, say if you had like a Volkswagen Beetle and you needed to go somewhere and run errands, you're not going to keep filling up on a full tank of gas every time you make a stop. You know, you went to the grocery store. Okay, now I need another full tank of gas. Now I went to the such and such spot. Now I need another full tank of gas. No, you don't really operate like that. You dig?
No, you good.
You tripping.
Yeah, I know you by now.
It's all good. But you know what I'm saying? But people do that when it comes to like that nutrition stuff. Like they eat food like they got to fill up on a full tank of gas.
Right.
Every single time that they eat.
That's the science.
And they're not going that far. You're not doing that much stuff in the day. So unless you got the activity level to match it, what are you going to do with all of this food? What are you going to do with all this energy you're taking in? Well, it's going to store in the places that your body stores it genetically, and there you go.
It's because that ghrelin, that hormone that makes you hungry, right? Yeah. It's a trick, too, because ghrelin.
Ghrelin. Okay.
That's the part that is like reminds you, hey, you should eat.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Problem is, like, you could like have like a quesadilla, right? And you know in your head, I could eat like 5 more of these motherfuckers right now. I could eat, you know what I'm saying? You know you can, but you know you shouldn't. Mm-hmm. But like you wait like 15, 10 minutes from that one quesadilla and you're just like, yo, I think I'm good. Like I'm not even hungry anymore because that ghrelin went away.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? So it's always been like a timing thing. If you eat slowly and you allow your body to adjust and like, you know, let it find out later that, hey, you're good.
Yeah.
Then you're going to be all right.
Mm-hmm.
Problem is, you know, sometimes the weed.
He said the weed.
The weed, you know, the THC will drop your blood sugar.
Ha! That's if you're, yeah, that's for those that are smokers. But I, what 80's touching on, you know, in physical fitness, we call it satiety. Like, so like your satisfaction, right? All right. So when your body, what he's saying is like your body does have a chemical reaction for satisfaction of food. Right? Now here's the thing what people don't understand about sugar. Sugar doesn't really register a satiety in the brain. So that's why you can consume so much of it and not really feel satisfied.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And that ends up being up the problem right there is because you're taking in so much sugar. It's not that sugar itself alone causes fat.
Yeah.
Talk to
him. It's not about that. It's the fact that you can't get a satisfaction chemically from it in the brain until you've consumed so much.
So much, huh?
That is way too much for you. Right? With other foods, proteins, and other stuff like that, you get a satiety quicker. So you're satisfied quicker. Your brain says, stop eating. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm sad. Stop eating.
Right, right.
And that's why you have to train your brain to eat foods that trigger that satiety gene in your brain. So you
train your brain.
You stop eating. That one jewel is just how important nutrition is.
Jewel, G. Yeah.
You won't learn that if you're just getting in the gym worrying about moving something from point A to point B.
Right.
You're missing a lot.
Right, right,
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So that's why I think it's important to get a real good instructor, no matter where you get it, get a real good sound person that really knows their stuff, you know?
Right, right.
You know, and just another tip I'll give you, this is one thing, man, anybody out there, if you out there and you shop for somebody and you're trying to, you know, go against your little fitness goal or whatever, your fitness goal, make sure that they, before they put you on any kind of equipment, before they work you out, show you how to do a push-up, make sure they do what's called a PARQ assessment. Now, this is something that they have to do and sit down and assess you to make sure you're ready for exercise. That's what they have to do. So they have to ask you a bunch of questions, ask you what's going on.
See, I would like that.
What kind of job you got going on? You sit on, you know, you sedentary most of the day. Mm. How often are you eating? You know,
right.
What's going on with you socially? Have you been sad? Have you lost any fat? Have you been depressed? All these different things play into your nutrition choices. Mm. They play into your activity level, your motivation level, and all of that. So if you guys out there, you get somebody to tell you, pay for $500, and the first thing they do is they sit you on a piece of workout equipment. Right. Bogus.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Bogus. They're bogus. They should sit down with a pen and pad with a PARQ assessment and be asking you a lot of very thorough questions. They should take that information and then develop a program and get you started right where you need to be. Right. Yeah, it should be catered to you.
And that's you always consider if they're an ectomorph, mesomorph, or endomorph.
A lot of stuff. There's a lot of things you got to factor because people have different religious beliefs and they eat different ways. You know? 7-day Adventists, they don't eat certain meats on certain days. You know, there's a lot of people who don't consume meat at all.
Right.
Certain stuff like that. And then there's some people that eat meat, but they only eat certain parts of the meat, like how it's cut.
Okay.
Yeah. They won't. They depending on how the meat is slaughtered.
Wow.
That's before you even get to the vegetarian and the vegan breakdown, right? And the difference in that.
Shout out to Master Mix.
Yeah, there's a lot of details there. So you got to get. You got to debate the real nutshell of that is you got to really shop around wisely. Shop wisely when it comes to your goals. When it comes to your body.
That's right.
Just like you do when you go to a specialist, a physician, or whatever. Your family doctor can only do so much, but he's not a surgeon. So he shouldn't be putting you on no gurney, giving you anesthesia, giving you surgery, right? He has to refer you to a surgeon, right? Refer you to a specialist. You know, you ever gone to the doctor and get a referral? That's what it is, right? You need a referral, right? Well, that's the same thing. People have to know their practice scope. So if the person doesn't really understand what they're doing, then hopefully they're smart enough to give you a referral and get you to a specialist that really does.
Getting it real, man.
That's what's up.
I love it. I love it like that. Give it up real. Man, that's crazy.
Yeah. So that's what it is, man. So, yeah, but if you want it right, you know where to find your boy.
There you go. Yeah.
You know where to find your brand that's going to get it right. You know?
Shout out to Master Rick.
Yeah, shout out to Master Mix Rick.
Whoop, whoop.
It's not about the cash. He's going to make it's not about the cash. It's about positive frequencies. There you go.
Hey, I like that.
Shout out to you, Rick. What's good?
I like that.
Shout out to everybody in Fresno. Fresno, my man Rick got a dope. He makes some of the best coconut smoothies.
Oh,
smoothies! Dope. He got a smoothie spot out there.
Woo! I'm about to come see you, bro.
Yeah, about to come. Yo, shout it out. So, and peace to everybody who's got things going on like that. You know what I mean, their own business and doing positive vibes, and you know, like you not just a hip hop artist, but you also. Work out and
do fitness and that kind of thing. This is a good time. I think this is a perfect time, even though we've had the unfortunate aspect of the COVID, and all of the things going on with the pandemic.
Yeah.
I think this is a good time. And I think a lot of people are taking advantage of this too, where like they tap it into their stuff a little bit more. They tap it into their creative side. They've had to work from home. They've had time to sit and go, damn, like now I got time to paint that picture.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I got time to redecorate that room now. And everybody's finding their stuff.
There you go.
They're finding their creative niche. I say run with it. Don't put it back in the pocket because they say, oh, the country's open now. You can go back to your job. Everything can go back to normal. No.
That's going to be a while.
Here's the window here. Do your thing right now. Do your thing right now. Whatever idea you got, I'm going to tell you, do it.
Just do it now.
Just do it. Don't even think about it. No matter what you got to start with, just start with doing it. Trust me.
There you go.
That's what's up. I did that.
And it's a jewel.
I got the show that you were on, the cage.
Yeah,
it was just something that I started because it was like I had always said that. I was like, yo, man, I'd love to do a talk show. I'd love to be able to interview some of my friends, show some of my people I know on the music side.
Right, right.
Then some of my people I know on the health and fitness side. I know so many different people.
Yeah.
And
come on, man.
And they're beautiful. They're beautiful. They got so much stuff that they got. It's like, I want to expose them. And you just being on a regular show, nobody's going to expose that better than me because I'm going to know you better.
Right.
And I'm going to know what to show people that they can't see. You understand what I'm saying?
That's right.
So that's where the cage came from. I just started like, I'm going to start doing this kind of thing and create my own show.
Where can people check out your IG show?
They can check the show out on my IG. That's why you got to follow me. So go on there, @live@1000fitness. I think only call it by I don't even keep track of it, but I think I've only got a few followers, but I should have like 20,000 some people following me, and I don't, because I guess I'm just not all on it like that. I need to get more into it like that. So help out.
Hey,
follow your boy, man. Follow your boy.
Because
I think people take that real serious. They be like, wait a minute, he got only 700, 800 followers? Nah, he don't know enough. Nah,
not these guys, though.
He needs to have 30,000 followers first before I mess with him, you know what I'm saying? So.
These guys and girls, they come through, and but you don't even know that why you saying that is a lot of people that want to get to it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. There's people out there that's really looking into it. And you touching a lot of people right now by telling them that.
Yeah.
You know, we don't see it all.
Yeah.
But,
yeah, we don't always see it. No, I get it. I get the flowers back so many different ways, man. I get some very beautiful feedback from folks. They always be like, they be like, yo, man, like, man, you know, I appreciate what you're doing, man. Keep doing it. I think, you know.
Right.
A lot of people are shy and they don't like to put it, you know, where the public can see it and stuff. So they'll send you the DM message and stuff. But it's still so rewarding. It's like dope. Like, yo, man, I've been following your tips and, you know, I lost 30 pounds and I've been dealing with this. My mother died and what you said about whoop-de-whoop really helped, bro. Yeah. Keep saying what you said. And it'd be just those days when I'd be like, man, I don't feel like they don't, you know, they got 1,000 other people to follow. I ain't even wasting my breath today. And then I'll get that message and it'll be like, damn, okay, well, shit. I guess it does matter to somebody. Let me. Let's keep it popping.
That's what it is. We be in the studio. Yep. We do work.
Yep.
It happened already. But then when they get it, they, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Yep. By the time people get the work and, you know, they don't even really see all the different stuff that's going on behind you and in your regular life that before you can even execute said idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now you're supposed to be performing like Friday, right?
Tomorrow. So tomorrow,
I'm tuning in for that shit. Yeah, I'm watching.
Tune in, everybody. Tune in. I'll be performing
popcorn and shit.
Yep. Exactly.
I'm gonna give me a bag of Funyuns for that.
Yes, it's to promote the CD that
Rockin' Nebula, right?
Yeah, Rockin' to Nebula. The pre-orders for Rockin' to Nebula will be tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna be shooting out there, and I'll be doing a performance.
Go get it.
So we'll have some fun tomorrow, and it's going to be fun. Yeah.
And they could pre-order the CDs on killerpriest.tv.
Right. And you got a limited edition. Man, we're going to keep it going. But, you know, we got it. With edition. Huh?
The album or the CD?
The CD. Okay. Well, we have the vinyl. I said vinyl. I always say 12 inch. But no, it's the vinyl. It's the vinyl. The vinyl, you can get that right now on Bandcamp. Make sure you go get that if you're out there. You know, go grab that vinyl because it's a limited edition. You can get one with me signing it or just get it. But get it because this is my first time ever doing the vinyl. They straight up like that.
That's huge. So,
you know, on an independent tip, I just always threw the CDs.
So, yo, DJs.
We did something with Psychic World, but that was later on.
DJs, go get that. You already know how scarce vinyl is anyway. Killer Priest vinyl.
Yeah.
Killer Priest vinyl. I know some DJs is gonna be like want their hands on that.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. And the cover, and y'all gotta remember. And let me say something about one of the songs on I think it's 60. No, Contact High. They don't realize that I actually typed those lyrics, and then you hear the computer.
Oh, that's dope.
Actually typed the lyrics through there. So that's a little jewel for y'all because. The cover, everything on this is different. So the cover is not what you see. It's not really a tree.
Right.
And that's not really, clouds. So that was typed. So if y'all hear, when y'all listen to Contact High again, that's actually me typing out the lyrics. So
that's funny.
Yeah. So,
that's dope.
And the computer is saying it for me.
That's some dope stuff. Like when you get like those.
I got on my Stevie Wonder.
That's dope when you get like that natural stuff in the song and the natural stuff being there.
Yeah.
That dope element like that.
Yeah, man.
Like, that's one thing Lil Jon pointed out on, you know, that one record that they got where it sounds like it's a bed squeaking?
Yeah.
What's up? You know that record?
Yeah.
He said that it was just his chair in the studio. It was a squeaky chair.
That's dope.
It's not a bed squeaking. He just
was, that's how creation is.
He said he was dropping his part and it was just, he was bouncing.
Yeah.
And it was going,
And
that's what got on the
crazy.
Track. Ain't that crazy?
It happens like that.
Yeah, it happens like that. That's beautiful.
It happened.
How you doing in the chat, y'all? What's good?
SW,
don't
yo, man.
The fam.
Yeah, make sure y'all.
How y'all doing?
Yep. Wow, that Rihanna sample. Oh, yeah, you caught that Rihanna? Yes, indeed. Yes, that's the same song. Yeah, it's the same song. Contact High.
That's funny. I had an old song called Contact Buzz a long time ago. That's crazy.
Dope, yeah. Mm. Yeah, man. So it was a good vibe. Yeah, man.
I want to see your project mass, man. I want to see it go, man.
Oh, thank you, brother.
It's dope, man.
Thank you, man.
I like seeing cats with dope shit go, man, because it sucks, man, when people just like, it misses ears. And then 10 years later, when it's an old joint, they be like, yo, when you put this out?
Right.
This shit? I only had a whole promotion.
Right.
I only spent like several months shoving it down your throat. Yeah.
But it's like you said, it's like because of the COVID-19, I think that it gave me time to relax and really put
chill into this album.
Yeah,
and take your time.
And at the end of it, you know what I mean? Because what they hear now is, you know, I took things off and mm-hmm. you know how it is.
Yeah, you get to sit there and adjust it and you sit there and live with it.
Yeah.
Yep. So you get the best stuff. Yeah.
Yep. So that's the best. Yeah, Easter egg. This is a little Easter egg for y'all.
Dope.
Word. Yeah, man. So
now y'all gonna see me crashing all the like Killer Priest shows now. You're gonna see why. I'm gonna be like the fan outside. It's gonna be me. I know Pre. What you saw? I was on the podcast. We been talking. Look up that one episode that time. We was having laughs and shit. And I was there. Dude. It was me. I don't need no damn ID. What you talking about? ID.
Neil asked me, what's the story behind you know, I explained that. You still got that what I sent you for the I did like a bonus CD.
Okay.
So we're gonna do a bonus CD too. And a bonus, I was explaining certain songs, but I'll tell you a little bit about the story behind Bob Ross. I just did it a little bit. I just told you I wanted the whole vibe as a Bob Ross.
Okay.
But like, why did you choose it? Just because you liked him growing up?
Yeah, it was just cool. It was something about the Happy Trees, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then,
it just stood out to you.
Yeah. And then the songs, the whole vibe. So I was like, man, this is sound like Bob Ross. You know what I mean? Something he would do.
I'm going to tell you one thing I really like on your projects, man, that you guys do very well. And I'm like, how the fuck do they be finding this kind of shit? Like how you use the Visionaries theme.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Visionaries. Yes. And y'all use this shit from like the classic superhero shows and the comic.
I'm like,
what the fuck?
Yeah.
When I hear that kind of stuff, I get mad at producers I know. Like, dude, this is what I'm talking about. Dig deep. This is the kind of shit that's so fucking dope. Visionaries, I'm going crazy. Like, are you kidding me? Visionary. I grew up on that TV show. Yeah. I'm sitting there watching it.
Yeah.
I love how you guys like use like the little voiceovers.
Yeah.
And you use the little bitty parables and stuff from little shows that only people would know if they was like watching that when they was a kid growing up. Like, that's ill. I think that's so dope how y'all do that, man.
Oh, thanks, man. It's just trying to create the vibe and everything.
Yeah, that's dope, man. Like, it's dope. And then, like, how you set up songs like that. You guys will use, like, a cool little intro like that, you dig? And then, you know, you guys will go right into the joint. And it is, like, it starts off like it's going to be something all sweet and shit. And then it comes into some ill shit. It's like, oh, what the fuck? Nah, that's dope.
Thanks, brother.
Really dope.
Yo, I want to say, David Flores, did you speak to Sean about that idea? Just say whatever. Just let me know. Yo, what's good, man? We about to land this plane. I mean, we circling the base, but how many viewers we got? Is that
I don't
it?
Know.
About 70.
Yeah. All right. Yo, man. Thank you for, anything else you want to say?
No, man. I appreciate y'all for just having me, man. I thank you guys out there for, like, having me too, man. Thanks so much, man. This was great. This was really dope. Check out the show I'm on, The Cage, man. It's every Wednesday. For right now, it's every Wednesday, 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Over on my IG at Live at 1000 Fitness. And, you know, just follow me anyway if you want to hang out. You know, sometimes I post, like, fitness videos. You'll see me posting stuff, and I'll give you some info. Sometimes I post some music. Sometimes I post some fun stuff. But, you know, it's always some food. That's what it is. So, either way. You can check me out on Facebook, too. On Facebook, I'm under my name, Tony Lowry. There's only one of me. So, if you see the same guy, then it's me. If you don't see me, then, you don't see Live at 1000, then it's not me.
No doubt.
All right, but I appreciate y'all, man. Tony Tiger Style out, man. That's what's up.
Yo, thank y'all for tuning in. Yo, tune in the next time we do this.
Whoop, whoop.
AD, shout out to him.
Yes,
shout
sir.
Out to everybody in the building. Whoop, whoop. Chanel over there. Whoop, peace. Whoop. Yo.
Chanel, that's what's up. Peace, AD.
Tiger Style. Peace. And I'm out of here.
Whoop, whoop. There it is.
All right.
That's what's up. We're going to end with
Grandmother's Land. Lived about 8 clans.
Grandmother's Land.
This is dope. Oh, animated video.
Oh, yeah.
That's
thanks,
so dope.
Man.
Yeah, I wanted to get somebody to do one for me like this to an animated dude.
Yeah.
That's dope
thanks.
Shit.
During the vision ceremony. We haven't seen him since. Agitated.
That's the best shit ever when you can do some shit like this. Because it just totally makes the vision.
No, you get it, man. Yeah, no, you. I'm a fan, bro. You get it. You get it. Yo, man.
I get it.
You get it. Yeah. And plus, you from the era. Yeah. I can tell. I've been listening to you. Yeah, I've been listening to what you saying. Like the visionaries. It's not catching all that stuff.
Visionary.
Yeah. A lot of cats
with the sound effects and everything. I'm like, oh, fuck.
Do you remember drawing this?
Yeah, see, there we go. They still hear us?
That's dope.
To see an event. Our visions did.
This is dope.
And you warned us of the ants before we slipped into a trance. Little Waters and you over there. You this put an so eagle feather in his hand. I know because during the ceremony I glanced. You said you felt the power of the yak and the elk. Little Waters played the drums to bring back your health. The chief said, please, tall bear, relax yourself. Maybe we should bring in some tribes women and ask them for help. So as the night stormed, tall bear went on how they spoke on upper plains and other life forms, and how Little Waters captured the bison, revisited their boyhood, the joys of the white owl in the oak woods, the spirit journey to the snow wars, did the horse dance, sing a rain song, how he came and gone, this is no good. Chief said, tall bear, I knew and spoke to you for many years. I wish your grandfather was still here, but this case is so rare. People and memories just don't disappear. I have no idea, but please have a seat right here. Maybe you're going crazy. Have you had sleep lately? Then he called for the tribes and the medicine ladies. They arrived with great urgency. What's the emergency? Chief said, tall bear needs your care. They all look confused. They all ask, who? Chief said, ask him yourself. They looked around the room and said, chief, who are you talking to? The chief said, tall bear, he's sitting right there. They asked, where? There's no one else here except us and you. The chief eyes stunned with terror and fear. His face just flared. Moments go by as they all just stare. Hours later, the children walk in the teepee from behind their backs, then look around the circle, then ask, what are y'all staring at? The spider lady turned and said, the chief is very sick and hallucinating. The children said, what chief? From outside, y'all sound like y'all was talking to the ancient. For years, it was only us, near the tree called Wounded Knee. Above the hills, who would sue and the big waters run free. By the white lake, the night draped in silence over undiscovered landscapes. Daybreak, pine mountains, drink from the many puddles that the rain makes. Bushes of trumpet flowers, wild grapes, marsh showers, and grass snakes. As the sun bakes the empty space near White Lake and Wounded Knee, the birds fly from the tree, cause every now and then that place shakes, the ground trembles. Just in that spot, on the right night, you can feel a mild earthquake. Grandmother's land. In grandmother's land. In the grandmother's land, the time first began. Who was there? Tall Bear? Little Waters? The chief? Or was it incomplete? Were the three really there? Or the medicine ladies? And grandmother's land, grandmother's land, grandmother's land, grandmother's land, grandmother's land, grandmother's land, wine time.
And grandmother's land, in grandmother's land, were they ever there? The tall bear, the chief, and little water, and grandmother's land. In grandmother's land, were they ever there? The tall bear, the chief, and little waters. In grandmother's land, we walk the burning sand.